All right, we're gonna do it. We're gonna do Xanadu. Oh, I almost fell. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to Xanadu by Rush off of their album Farewell to Kings, or Of Farewell to Kings, released in 1977. This will be a song review because I've already done this song over on JPMP. However, so many of you guys in the comments, Do Xanadu again. Just do it again. So I'm going to do it again. Exit stage left. I've already seen it. I've already heard the song. I always watch the live versions after the song. So a lot of times I don't like to go back and redo songs that I've already done on the other channel, only because there's so much music to explore. And I'd rather like focus on songs and bands or whatever that I haven't heard already. But every once in a while, whether it's by me wanting to kind of revisit a song because it might change my mind, or maybe I might feel different on it, or because, you know, you guys just asked for it so much. I thought, you know what, let's revisit this one. I want to. It is never a problem for me to listen to more Rush, so that doesn't bother me at all. Anyways, I hope that you guys are having a fantastic day. I hope that you guys understand just how powerful your voice is. I heard you. And by the way, this video is actually recorded after I've already listened to Closer to the Heart. And that video has already been recorded, so I'm pretty sure in that video I say that I'm not going to listen to the song. Just ignore future Justin, okay? Just ignore him sometimes. Anyways, join me on Twitter. Join me in the comments down below. Hope you're having a beautiful, sunny, just blossoming day. And let's do it. This is Xanadu by Rush. Thank you.
see the sacred river out, to walk the caves of ice, to break my fast on honeydew, and drink the milk of paradise. I have heard the whisper tales of immortality, but even mystery from an ancient book. To stand within the pleasure dome decreed by Kubla Khan, to taste anew the fruits of life, the last immortal man. Find the sacred river out, to walk the caves of ice. Oh, I will dine on honeydew and drink the waiting for the world to end, weary of the night, praying for the light, resin of the lost Xanadu. We'll be right back.
I mean, I've said it all before. There's a few things I really like about this song. One is the adventurous spirit of it. Of course, by the lyrics, but just by the music, just by the scale of it. We've already heard 2112. We know what they can do when they got 20 minutes on their hands. And I'm sure some of their other songs previously, as we've heard as well, you know, they can do a lot in a little bit of time, and they can do a lot in a lot of time. This song, at about 10 minutes, is like, to me, a mini epic. A perfectly encapsulated journey, right? Through mystical lands, searching for paradise, and Kublai Khan, and Xanadu, this mysterious and mystical land is real, I don't know. It feels like an Indiana Jones kind of movie, just by the scale of it. But I really like how they open it up, which leads me to the second thing I really like about this song, which is just the use of the percussion, right? Peart. Man's a genius. I love the way he plays, of course, drums, but just using different kinds of sounds, different forms of percussion, not only in the opening, but also at different parts throughout the song as well. For example, especially if you watch, you know, Exit Stage Left, you can see the sheer half circle of other, you know, bells and drums and sounds that he has around him. Notably, the tubular bells, which we hear in here as well. So it's just really cool how all of these different things are utilized. Which brings me to my third point, the use of the synthesizers. This is one of those songs, and I believe one of their first songs, in which the synths were so heavily used. And I think that they use it in a perfect way. For example, in the beginning, Geddy is using the synths there with his feet. See, I got the visual. I've seen it. And the way that it sets up this mythical journey that's about to take place. The way that it kind of, at least for me, makes me think of like mystical lands and giant valleys, and the winds are just kind of swinging and singing through the valleys. They're kind of whistling through. You can feel yourself kind of looking at this mystical land and then immediately being sucked out of that mystical land as we're thrown into the first riff, which is interrupted by Alex. It's a fantastic riff, by the way. But before the song and the journey gets underway when Geddy steps in. By the way, if you don't like Geddy singing, I'm sure that this song is one of the ones that you probably hated singing, because he definitely hits some of those higher notes in this one, and he really stretches his vocal cords on here. But can I tell you? I like it. I don't always love, like, the higher parts, and here, I actually don't love all of the higher notes that he hits. At some points, it gets a little bit much for me, but I do enjoy the intensity that he brings with it. So it's a little bit of a half and half kind of situation. But yeah, I think that a lot of bands would misuse this synthesizer. I think a lot of bands would get this new toy and say, okay, let's just throw everything out. But no, Rush has a nice quiet restraint. And speaking of restraint, when the first few rolls and drum fills come in by Peart in that nice, grand, climactic opening to this particular section, there's a lot of patience and restraint on Peart's part. Listen to how he builds up the fills. Most of the time in those moments, doing the fills just a few quick ones near the ending of the beat, and then as that section goes on and begins to expand, he begins to throw in bigger and longer fills. Each one more epic than the last, and each one making you look forward to the next one. Short one, just a snare, toss it. Okay, little bit more. Little bit more. A little bit more. And it just goes from there, but I think you get the point. And this is a fun, bouncy groove that they get into right here. Classic Rush. Really like the elongated ending as it begins to get into the verse. Yeah, that's cool. And then we get this really nice riff by Alex. A little bit more percussion coming in on the back end of it. A little more synth. Not completely throwing out those elements that they just built on. That is how you make a good journey. And in this section, when the music first is introduced, Geddy's first introduced, it's very soft. It's still retaining that mystical quality, but it's just a little more epic, you know, just a little bit more feeling in it. I love the synth and the bass combination. That sounds really nice. I really like, and I mention this a lot, and I think it's underrated, I really like how lyrics match music. So this section right here, where it's still kind of reflective and still kind of quiet, I love the dreamy synth work. Geddy is saying, he's repeating basically a story. He's saying, to seek the sacred river Alph, to walk the caves of ice, to break my fast on honeydew and drink the milk of paradise. Okay, he's actually just quoting like a story that he's heard, this legend, this myth. And the dreamy quality of the music kind of perfectly accents that and captures it. But listen. I can have the whisper tales of immortality. First of all, I love the way that the verse is built, from that soft into the hard. But when it jumps into the heavy section, like I said, it's like we're seeing visions of this beautiful place and then we're sucked back into reality. And he says, I had heard whispered tales of immortality, the deepest mystery. From an ancient book, I took a clue. I scaled the frozen mountaintops. He has begun his journey and it is not an easy journey. So immediately sucked in from the fantasy and drawn back into the harsh reality of trying to accomplish and reach that fantasy. I like that. I like the way that Rush does that. And come on, those fills in between, tasty. Yeah. And then after that, it's almost like he's done reflecting and just wants to get back to scaling this mountain and trying to find this place that he's so wanting to find. And listen, once again, the music changes into something just as heavy, but a little bit more celebratory. He's almost crying out with joy as he's found this place. And that's where I really enjoy Geddy singing. I really like the way that he just exclaims himself here. Right? Like, he's just happy. He's like, paradise, this is it. I've found it. And even his playing alongside of him singing is so happy and so joyous. Okay, I think it is so funny. And I think that there's at least a little bit of a sense of humor here. All right, repeating the same verse when before it was capturing the adventure. It was capturing the idea of searching for this lost land, this romantic ideal. But then here, he's already found the land. He's already become immortal. And at this point, lyrically, he's saying 1,000 years have come and gone. Time has passed me by. Stars stopped in the sky, frozen in an everlasting view. Waiting for the world to end, weary of the night, praying for the light. Prison of the lost Xanadu. Yeah, he's in Xanadu. He is bored out of his mind. He's tired of living. He's waiting for just something else. He feels like he's stuck. He's a prisoner in time. I like how the music is the same, but now the message within it has changed. Woo! Killer drumming, killer singing. Love the guitar, love the bass. I kind of like everything about this song, besides a few of the higher notes I don't quite love. But same thing, let's go back to the lyrics. At this point, reflecting on his imprisonment, held within the pleasure dome decreed by Kublai Khan. I can't say it. Held within the pleasure dome decreed by Kublai Khan to taste my bitter triumph as a mad immortal man. Never shall I return, escape these caves of ice. He found what he was looking for. He's stuck in the pleasure dome. That sounds like a good place to be. But now it's a prison instead of like this destination that he was trying to find. To taste his bitter triumph. He's triumphant, but it's bittersweet. As a mad immortal man. That's not good. For I have dined on honeydew and drunk the milk of paradise. Whoa, is it paradise? I guess in some eyes, yes. But in some eyes which have tasted it, not exactly. Paradise or prison? You can even hear that in his higher singing here. It's a little bit more angsty here. I guess a lot more angsty. But he's like, man, I shouldn't have came here. Fantastic song, especially ending side one of the album. And like I said before, I feel like if you had put on this album after you had already listened to 2112 and this was the new Rush album and you put this on when you got home, I mean, I'm pretty sure you would be more than impressed. I mean, come on, let's be honest. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Of course, you can join me down in the comments below. Definitely let me know what you thought of the song. You can join me on Twitter as well. Sometimes I post random stuff there or ask a question or two. I don't know, just join me there. Hope you guys have a fantastic day. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.